Exactly. Why not? I scratched my head in perplexity. You see, it sounded like tommyrot, and yet I had to admit the possibility of the thing. The explanation of all these things is, of course, that it isn't the eye that sees, but the brain. The eye merely receives the light and sight which waves are thrown off by all physical objects within the range of its vision, and transmits them to the brain. Light waves are motion waves, heat and light being merely forms of motion, as of course you know. The retina is so constructed that it can absorb these light waves and communicate the vibrations thus received to the brain. The brain does the seeing. Now imagine a different sort of light wave, and there is no reason for supposing that the brain could not absorb it directly without the assistance of the retina. But you were talking about mental telepathy, I said. This does not explain how you can read another's thoughts, even if it shows the theoretical possibility of seeing things with your eyes shut. For mind to communicate with mind, all you have to presuppose are mind waves, answered Migraine. But the thing is perfectly well understood in science. It is a recognized fact. Do you want another cigar? Very good. Wait. Almost instantly, the door opened and Saki entered bearing a tray of large, evenly rolled Havanas, which he smilingly tendered to me. I must have made a botch of picking them off the tray, for Migraine began to laugh heartily, and I found myself holding half a dozen cigars in my fist and staring fixedly at Saki's scalp as he moved noiselessly away. The fellow did have patches of nice, black, shining hair mingled with the gray. "Tell the gentleman your age, Saki," directed Migraine. The Jap turned on his heel. 110, he said simply. "Jumping Jehoshaphat!" I exclaimed to Migraine. "Do you expect me to believe him?" The doctor shrugged his shoulders. "It's nothing to me whether you believe him or not," he replied. But I was piqued that a sensible, hard-headed man of a business like myself could not put the kibosh on all this nonsense more readily. Down at the office, they always come to me when they want someone to spot the fallacy in any new theory of how to corner Union Pacific. So I thought hard for a moment. Then it came to me. Very well, I replied confidently. If it's not the eye, but the brain that sees, it must be the brain and not the tongue that tastes, not the fingers, but the brain that feels, not the nose. Precisely, said Migraine. Huh? I shouted. Then I suppose you will be telling me next that there is nothing to prevent my smelling an Indian bazaar over in the Calcutta somewhere, or feeling some fellow chopping wood over in Central Park, or... You've got it, he replied. You've caught the idea.